The Great Chicago Fire started on Sunday evening, October 8, 1871, in the barn of Mr. and Mrs. Patrick and Catherine O'Leary. Legend has it that Catherine O'Leary's cow kicked over a lantern, starting the fire. The fire died out in the early morning of Tuesday, October 10th. 300 people lost their lives, 17,450 buildings were destroyed, and 100,000 people were left homeless. Dry weather and many wooden buildings made Chicago at risk to fires. In 1870, Chicago averaged 2 fires per day, and there were 20 fires throughout Chicago the week before the Great Fire of 1871. Reconstruction efforts began quickly. These efforts encouraged great economic development and population growth, as architects laid the foundation for a modern city featuring the world's first skyscrapers.
In 1894, police discovered the badly burned body of a man inside a small patent office on Callowhill Street in Philadelphia. The body was soon identified as Henry Willard Mudgett's business partner, Benjamin Pitezel. Later that year, the bodies of 2 of Pitezel's children were found in Toronto, and the remains of another shoved down a chimney in Indianapolis. Police on Pitezel's trial arrested Henry Mudgett under the alias Dr. Henry Howard Holmes in Boston and put him on trial for the murder of Pitezel. As police began to investigate Holmes, they uncovered years of his life that had been hidden behind aliases and countless wives to cover up his assembly line mentality for murder. He eventually confessed to 27 murders, but could quite possibly be responsible for 200 bodies.
Since being elected president in 1896, McKinley was known for disregarding his own personal safety at public appearances. Just months into his second presidential term, McKinley made the most significant speech of his presidency, the day before announcing a policy of reciprocal trade agreements with foreign nations to encourage and improve markets for American goods. On September 5th, the day before his assassination, he announced in his speech that isolation is no longer possible or desirable, and that the period of exclusiveness is past. Republican President McKinley was the 3rd president to be assassinated in our nation's history. While holding a reception on September 6, 1901, in the Temple of Music at the Pan American Exposition in Buffalo, he was shot by Leon Czolgosz. Leon waited in a long line for 2 hours to shake hands with McKinley. He waited in 82-degree temperature heat with a fake bandaged right arm. McKinley saw the man's apparent disability and greeted him with a handshake and smile. He reached to shake his left hand. Suddenly, Leon Czolgosz thrust his bandaged arm hand into the president's chest. Onlookers heard 2 sharp popping sounds. McKinley looked confused and suddenly clutched his chest and leaned forward. Members at the incident moved to support the slumbering president and help him to a nearby chair as the blood spread across his white vest. One bullet struck his sternum, causing only a superficial wound, but the other had penetrated his abdomen, a potentially fatal injury. At 5:20 p.m., an hour and 13 minutes after the shooting, President McKinley had surgery. Physicians couldn't find the second bullet, and they explained that given McKinley's weakened condition, further search risked killing him on the operating table. Leon was then convicted as guilty in the first degree. McKinley eventually died on September 14, 1901 in Buffalo, New York. After McKinley was assassinated, President Roosevelt mourned for several minutes. When Roosevelt became president, he said, "I wish to say that it shall be my aim to continue absolutely unbroken the policy of President McKinley for the peace and prosperity and the honor of our beloved country."
The San Francisco earthquake was the world's first major natural disaster to have its effects recorded by photography. At 5:12 a.m. on April 18, 1906, the earthquake shook San Francisco. It lasted 40 to 60 seconds and measured 7.8 on the Richter scale. 30,000 homes were either partially or wholly destroyed, and an estimated 3,000 people were reported dead. The earthquake caused large parts of the city to burn and took 2 days of constant firefighting to stop the spread and bring the fires under control. The fires destroyed about 28,000 buildings and 500 blocks, which is 1/4 of San Francisco. The earthquake ruptured the ground surface along the San Andreas Fault for about 290 miles and was felt from southern Oregon to south of Los Angeles and inland as far as central Nevada.
Thank you.
On April 10, 1912, the Titanic left Southampton, England to voyage to New York City. She was supposedly the safest ship ever built. So safe that she carried only 20 lifeboats, which was only enough to hold half her 2,200 passengers and crew. On April 14th at 11:40 p.m., she struck an iceberg. The collision was fatal and the icy water soon poured through the ship. 2 hours and 40 minutes after the collision, the ship slowly began to sink. Each passenger had received a life jacket, but many died because the water was below freezing. The next morning, the liner Carpathia rescued 705 survivors, but 1,522 passengers and crew died. The insufficient number of lifeboats and inadequate training in their use led to the high number of deaths.
The world's largest ship and famous for its luxurious accommodations and speed capability, the Lusitania primarily ferried people and goods across the Atlantic Ocean between the United States and Great Britain. On May 1, 1915, the Lusitania left port in New York and was headed towards Liverpool to make her 202nd trip across the Atlantic Ocean. That morning, Captain William Thomas Turner slowed down the Lusitania because of fog and inability to see. This left the boat traveling in a very predictable line, making them an easy target for Germany. 6 days later, at 1:40 p.m. on May 7th, a German U-boat launched a torpedo that hit the starboard side of the Lusitania. Almost immediately, another explosion rocked the ship, causing the ship to sink in just 18 minutes. The final casualty figures were 1,201 men, women, and children dead out of the total 1,959 passengers on board. The wreck of the Lusitania lies in waters south of the Old Head of Kinsale, Ireland.
World War I began on July 28, 1914, when a Serbian terrorist shot an Austro-Hungarian Archduke in Sarajevo, Bosnia. The retaliation by Austria-Hungary against the Kingdom of Serbia activated a series of alliances that set off a chain reaction of war declarations. Within a month, much of Europe was in a state of open warfare. The war was propagated by two major alliances. In 1915, the Lusitania was sunk without a warning, killing over 120 Americans. 1 year later, the Sussex was sunk by German U-boats, and American citizens were outraged at these direct violations of their neutral rights at sea. At this point, a small percentage of Americans, including presidential hopeful Teddy Roosevelt, demanded immediate warfare. Americans began to put pressure on the U.S. government to enter the war. President Woodrow Wilson campaigned for a peaceful end to the war, but in 1917, when the Germans announced that their submarines would sink any ship that approached Britain, Wilson declared that America would enter the war and restore peace to Europe. 135 countries took part in World War I. The war lasted 4 years and ended on November 11, 1918. World War I resulted in most of Europe being destroyed, the surrender of Germany, and the signing of the Treaty of Versailles.